Hi, good morning girls and good morning all. Why I tell the word of girls? Because today I'm going to talking about something different topic, whatever. So before I say the sentence, the word of girl, I'm telling you one thing. Girl, sister, daughter, mother, etc. It's all everything coming one word is woman, girl. And what is the current situation, what is the current problem of the girls going on across the India compared to other countries? Yeah, first thing is what society thinks about a girl, thinks about a woman. That solution and what is the problem, I'll tell you. Always in our society, compared to girls, they have dropped down the girls. Everything, whatever happened, they will fast down the girls compared to boy. Then, coming to the second point, I have noted here, and I want every point, what I feel, and if it's correct or not. I'm going to discuss about all these points. So, you can give your feedbacks, comment over there, is this true or not. Second is gender equality, starting from our family itself. Gender equality, the most common problem across the India. Compared to a girl, we always give importance to the boy, starting from family to starting from. I'm not telling you in every family, compared to 60% of the family, before taking any decision for the girl, they will go for the boy first, in terms of education, in terms of spending money, everything. Family will think about a girl's marriage. Why should I spend money in education or spend money in marriage? So it will be limited for the girls. As always, boys will be tough. Then third thing, how the family treats a girl. It's not about every family. I'm thanks that my family never thinks like this, but it's about the other families. Like a small example, if a girl is going outside, where you are going, why you are going, and when you will be returned, if something late, then why it is so late. A similar type of question never be asked to a boy. Is it true or not? Okay, and the most common things, it's happening in villages, happening in many developed city also. Like many girls are fails to enroll their primary educations in India. This is the starting of their life, still they are forced to stop this. It sounds very bad, right? Primary education, they are stopping to the girls. It sounds very bad. Even as I am a girl, I feel very bad on this. Then the next topic I'm going to tell. 56%, as a research said, 56% girls sexually abused. I don't think girls don't have sense in India people or what. Why it is happening, I don't also understand. Is the education of India is very bad? If the thinking, people's thinking system is very bad or what? And most offensive thing is the child labor's rules is there, everything is there. Still it is happening, child labor's. And then going to the next topic, like when we cross to the education, when a girl is searching a job at the age of 21-22, finish after his education, now the family will think about their marriage. Even the girl want to do a job, they will tell what they will do by doing a job. Go for the marriage, go to the law, take care of your family, take care of your baby. This thinking of system in society and family, definitely it's forced to a girl do a marriage, and after marriage dowries will come. So many different type of issues come, especially dowry issues coming from the education peoples. And coming to the next topic, like if some women want to be financially independent, they want to help their family financially independent, thinking about with the single girls in your family, after marriage they went to his in-laws home, and that girl want to do the job and want to help his family, want to help his father, mother, it's possible. Yeah, some girls are doing, but most of India, that is not possible. After going to law, some thought complete things will be changed. They will they will think that take care of my family member, take care of babies. So it is not at all possible. I cannot imagine what the people's thinking persisting happening across the India. Then most major and most shameful things in India, which is rape cases. Safety of girls in India. 36,000 plus rapes is happening across India in a year. Every 1 hour there is a rape is happening in India. I don't know why people this is happening, why there is no strong rules, even after rules, why it is not implementing, and why it is happening in India compared to other country, why onset for a girl's child in India. And after this whole topic, then it's coming to domestic violence. Still it is the same things, domestic violence. Still it is happening with many education, many good education people. Still they are silent in domestic violence. They are not telling anything, thinking about society, thinking about what my father, mother will, and my relative will think. So domestic violence also, in that case, they are silent. And that is all. Then coming to the job interview also, if you are a married person, a married person, they will think about either he is able to give the time in the work or not. If you are pregnant, still the interviewer will think he is in pregnancy, after that small baby will come, then he will not giving consideration in the work and baby care. Many things they will think is prospective of girls before giving the job. But I want to say one thing to them, it's a nature things. So it's not like that I am having a kid and I will not concentrate in my work. There is a many successful entrepreneur, many successful peoples in ladies, they have to giving the best example in India, according to his home, according to take care of child, according to take care of the most branded companies like HSBC chairman, SBI chairman. Many people's example in terms of female, how they are handling both of things very well. So why this all are happening in these things? Is there any particular answer for this you can comment? And who is all responsible for this? I can say though, every citizen of people, every person, single person is responsible for this in India. If every person take responsibility their self to stop this thing from this family itself, from this village itself, from this circle itself, then it will definitely stop. Then I could say the last word in this, that a girl has power to change entire the world. So my dear girlfriends, my dear women, so why you are silent? Why you are not fight against this? Why you are stopping and forcing yourself, squeezing yourself? Until unless you will go higher, unless you will be in not prove yourself, nobody will care for you, even nobody will think about you. So every woman should grow himself, and they should not silence himself. There is a many rules, any regulation is there. In case any wrong thing happening, they should fight back, bounce back in that. And first of all, our mentalities should be changed in perspective of everything. You should not giving up, you should not crying, yeah, this is happening, but I can't do anything. You should not giving up, you should not crying ourselves. Move on, keep going, don't think the past, what is happening, keep prove yourself. This is what I'm suggesting to nowadays girls who are suffering in this issue. You are the only reason for you, you can fight back and you can fight on your issue, you can make an example for this issue. So coming to the first topic, what society thinks about the girl. My dear society person, who all are staying nearer to me and whatever my relatives and everything, is all are coming in society. Why is this necessary to think and commending the particular parents, particular girl, particular person about this issue? Like, if I am going crossing 27-28 years, why you are keeping your girls in home? Better you do your daughter to marriage. Is it necessary to commending? Is it necessary to do this? Why can't you change your mentality? Why you are suffering to other people, are influencing the other parents for that? Why can't you stop these things? It's a responsibility each and every person surrounding you, surrounding your society, to stopping this. Keep encouraging the girls, keep encouraging your women as like a family. Till then India will improve. As a girl will improve, girl will educated, then India will improve. Somebody say, if one girl will educated, entire family will educated. Then gender equality. If you have money for your daughter's marriage after 20 years, why don't you spend this money on your girl's education? When she will go for the job, she will get back of this money. She will do his own marriage, his own money. She have something identity that I have make this thing. So don't think about she is a girl. I have to think about her marriage in future. So I will stop his education. I will stop these things. Better I will spend this thing on my boy because he is going to stay here for long term. Can we say who make this marriage rule that after marriage girl will go this home, another home? He is going another home, that does not mean she didn't need any education. So please change your gender things, not only this topic, every topic, gender equality things. Okay, then the families. If your daughter is going out, your daughter-in-law is going out, then you can make safe for himself. That does not mean you will compare with boy and girl, why he is going, she should not go out, she should stay home. It's not like this. You should support him if he's doing anything good. You have to advise him if anything bad. It's not like completely stop anything bad is happening. Then many girls fail to enroll their primary education. I think in every village there will be one to minimum graduation level people, either it be a boy or girl. If in your village that girl is fails to doing education, then why don't you tell them, educate them? Because nowadays every primary education is free. It's not that much of chargeable, like can't afford this. You can take a responsibility, take him to the school, take his admission over there. And if you try for in your village with 10 girls, then definitely there is a changes in every village. So you can take a responsibility for your village, for your city, for your nearest area. Similar way, you can stop the child labors also. If any child is working there, you can say, you can educate people, this is wrong, what is right thing for them, how we can enroll them for the education. There is several system media is there, you can follow this, you can help them. Until you take a responsibility, until you help them, nothing will happen. Then going to the marriage, so when the daughter do the marriage, going to daughter-in-law house, after that is everything is totally wrong. I am leaving my house and coming here. You should be treated as same like a daughter, not like a daughter-in-law. You have to do this thing forcefully. You have to do this that thing forcefully. You have to leave your job. You have to take care of this thing. You should adjust. Why should you depend upon that someone will come and do this? Why don't you mix up and do this? This mentality, this thing should be there for everyone's mind in law's home, so that they will be happily leave your home. And dowry, is it necessary to take dowry? Is your son is not that much of ability to do these things? Why do you need of dowries? Even the educated people also asking for dowry. Did you understand what amount you are asking to this particular family? Is that amount is affordable to pay? How they are paying? And is it necessary to ask dowry? Without dowry, marriage can't happen. Without dowry, relation can't happen. Think like your daughter and think if this is correct or not. Still it is happening across the India. Many top level educated people's person, many high level post. They are also same issue is coming in India. I don't know why they are so aggressive in point of dowry. And safety of girls, like you can just imagine how many rape cases happening in the India, and how if this is happened, then definitely the parents will think twice before they are sending their daughters to for the job in outside, for studying in outside. So if everyone take responsibility, if anything happening wrong, suddenly oppose them, and it should be stopped from the starting level itself. The police should be strict, so the area charges person, in charge person should be strict, so that people will fear to do this thing. Everything, there is a thing is there, but which is not implementing in India. For that reason, these cases is going high. I don't want to discuss about this because this thing is very much available by everyone. So this can be stopped once the every system, judicial system, and every responsibility person is strict in their area, strict in their self. Then only it is happen. Then coming to domestic violence, it's not the same. You don't have a single authority to doing beating someone, hitting someone, doing abusing someone. It's like a domestic violence things. You don't have a single authority. And how can you do these things? It's coming to my mind. It's not a totally at a good sentence at all, domestic violence. Like it's still in same. How can you do this thing? Are you human or animal? Animal can do this thing. So these all are the primary responsibility, all of starting from family, starting from giving teaching to your child, so that it will not happen. What you are giving learning or teaching to your or child, that will they will only follow the this thing. So don't give money, and don't give some good things in their mind, so that this should not happen in future. And treat people is equally, so that this is not happening in future. And coming to the job interview things, and dear interviewer, dear companies, a married lady, that does not mean she will not concentrate his work. Still she is in office for 8-9 hours, still he is doing your works like a boy. He is a pregnancy, that does not mean she will not do his works, lapses of works and something else. Obviously this is a chance, nature of things, it will happen. That's why government having maternity laws and many bunch of laws. So why do we worry about this? Let give a chance to prove him. He's having a small baby, that is not a reason. She might have good talent. Still, this matter should not be thinking. This should not be like, I have faced many interview, who will take care of your baby while you are coming to job. This question not at all coming to an interviewer mind. Because nowadays many women entrepreneurs, nowadays many women are very successful position. They still have a family, they still have a baby. So this prosperity mind concept things to be changes. Only each and every person if taking responsibility. And also, my dear girls, for you also, you should not silent. You should not compromise, squeeze yourself in everything. You should, if you have a dream to become this thing, you should focus on your goal, plan for your aim, and improve yourself. Then only people know you. Then only people go behind you. Until you do this thing, people will blame you. People will do this, all of these things for you. So this is what current situations I want to discuss with you all. If you have any suggestion, feedback to improve this thing, you can comment here. So that we all can take a positive responsibility, we all can spread a positive awareness, so that women empowerment, so that everything can be a less thing in that. We as a young society, young man, young woman, if we all take a small responsibility, it will come a bigger way of result. So stay safe in home, keep take a small responsibility, make positive awareness across surrounding to yours. That is what I can say today. And last example I can say you before finishing this session. Can you see this? This is root. This tree is going. If this root is strong, then tree will go. If you cut this root, then definitely tree will not grow. And if I cut this thing middle of the tree, and after some day, if I take proper care of this thing, after some day it will also grow. Why I am giving this example? This is a tree. Compare this tree with your life, with yourself. If my root is strong, that means my aim is strong, my determination is strong, then only I will grow off. If the tree is broken and it is growing up, that means if I fail, if I was broken, still I have ability to grow off. If my mentality is strong, if my willpower and confidence is strong. So this is one small example I gave you, because you will understand the circumstance, you will understand the situation, accordingly you will react, accordingly you will do. Thank you.